Hello, good morning students. This is Dinesh sir. Today I am going to explain about the first chapter of standard 10, real numbers. Friends, in class 9 you began your exploration of the world of real numbers and encountered irrational numbers. We continue our discussion on real numbers in this chapter. We begin with two very important properties of positive integers in this chapter, namely the Euclid's division algorithm and fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Friends, first topic is Euclid's division lemma. Consider the two division of one positive integer by another, say 58 by 9. Right? You all know about 58 is known as a dividend and 9 is known as a divisor. Right? While carrying out this division, we had to think of about the largest multiple of 9, which is less than 58. Right? We know that the largest multiple of 9, which is less than 58, is 54. So 9 6 is 54. Now subtract 54 from 58, so 4 is remaining. Right? The result of this division is that we get two integers, namely 6 and 4. So 6 is known as Euclid's division lemma. Consider the division of one positive integer by another, say 58 divided by 9. While carrying out this division, we had to think of about the largest multiple of 9, which is less than 58. We know that the largest multiple of 9, which is less than 58, is 54. So 9 into 6 gives 54. So 9 54. Now subtract 54 from 58, so 4 is remaining, right? The result of this division is that we get two integers, namely 6 and 4. 6 is called quotient and 4 is called remainder, right? Friends, we can also write this result in the following form. That is, 58 is equals to divisor is 9, highest multiple of 6 plus 4. Right? So 58 is dividend, 9 is divisor, 6 is quotient, and 4 is remainder. Now one thing is very important, that remainder is always less than equals to 0 and less than divisor. So we can write 0 is less than equals to 4 is less than 9, right? Because we have 4 is remainder and 9 is divisor. Let us now apply the same procedure to another pair of positive integers, right? Say 25 is divided by 7. Again think about largest multiple of 7, which is less than 25, is 21. So 7 3 is 21. Now subtract 21 from 25, which is gives 0. Right? So this result we can write in the given form. This is 25 is equals to 7 into 3 plus 4, where remainder is less than equals to 0, 0 is less than 4, less than 7.
Okay.
This is first example. Second example is, second example, 20 is divided by 3. Again, think about largest multiple of 3, which is less than 20, is 18. 3 is 6, 18. Again, subtract 18 from 20 gives 2. Right? This result is also right in the form of 20 is equals to 3 into 6 plus 2, where remainder is equals to less than 0, 6, 2, less than 3. Here 2 is remainder, which is less than 0 or equals to 1 and less than divisor. Third example, 35 is divided by 5. Right? Let us think about the highest multiple of 7, which is less than 35, is 35 is itself. 5 sevens are 35. Subtraction 0, 0. Right? So I can write down in the form of 35 is equals to 5 into 7 plus 0, where remainder is always less than equals to 0. 0 is less than equals to 0, less than 5, because the 5 is the divisor. It is evident from the above discussion that the above representation also holds for the other pair of integers. We also observe that for each pair of positive integers a and b, we can find unique integers q and r satisfying the relation a is equals to bq plus r, where 0 is less than equals to r less than b. In fact, this holds for every pair of positive integers as proved in the following lemma. Euclid's division lemma. Let a and b, a and b be any positive integers then there exist unique integers q and r such that a is equals to bq plus r, comma, where 0 less than is equals to r less than is equals to b, right? So remainder is always less than equals to 0 and less than divisor. Friends, let us see how to find out highest common factor of the integers. Right? For example, find HCF, means highest common factor of 4052 and 12576. Since 12576 is larger than 4052, right? Since 12576 is greater than 4052, right? So 12576 become a dividend and 4052 is divisor. So 12576 is equals to 4052. Now think about the highest multiple of 4052, which is less than 12,000 576. If we multiply by 4052 by 3, we will get 12,156 and 420 become remainder. Right? For second step, divisor become dividend. So 4052 is equals to, and remainder become divisor 420. Now again think about the highest multiple of 420, which is less than 4052. If you multiply by 9, right, we will get 3780 plus 272 is remainder. Right? Again, now 420 become dividend, 420, and 272 become divisor, 272. Just multiply by 1, so remainder become 148. Right? 272 become dividend, 272 is equals to, and 148 become divisor, 148 into 1 plus 124. Now 148 become dividend, 148 is equals to 124 into 1 plus 24. Right? Right? Same process, 124 is equals to 24 into 5 plus 4. 24, 4, 5, 7, 20 and 4. 24 become dividend, 4 become divisor, 4, 6 are 24 and remainder 0. The remainder has now become 0, so our procedure stop. Since the divisor at this stage is 4, so the highest common factor HCF of 12,576 and 4052 is 4. Is it clear, friends? Friends, homework 4, this example is find HCF of first 135 and 225. Second sum is 196 and 38,220 by Euclid's division algorithm. Euclid's division algorithm has several applications related to finding properties of numbers. Let us see some examples of these applications. Show that any positive even integer is of the form of 2q, and that every positive odd integer is of the form of 2q plus 1, where q is some integers. Right? Let a be any positive integer. Integer and b is equals to 2, right? Then by Euclid's, division lemma, there exist U and R such that A is equal to BQ plus R, where 0 is less than equals to R less than B. Now we have B is equals to 2, therefore next step is A is equals to 2Q plus R, where 0 is less than is equals to R less than 2. Right? Now remainder is always less than 2 or equals to 0. So in R is equals to 0 and 1. Now we have A is equals to 2Q plus R. So consider R is equals to 0, then A is equals to 2Q plus R, therefore A is equals to 2Q plus 0, therefore A is equals to 2Q. Right? If R is equals to 1, then A is equals to 2Q plus R, replacing R is equals to 1, so 2Q plus 1. You can see from the above discussion, right? If A is equals to 2Q plus, A is equals to 2Q, then A is an even integer, while A is equals to 2Q plus 1, then A is an odd integer. Is it clear, friends? Is there any query, then you can ask me. Okay, let us see another example. Example number 2. Show that any positive odd integer is of the form of 4q plus 1 or 4q plus 3, where q is some integers. Again, let a be any positive integer. Let a be any odd positive integer. Integer and b is equals to 4. Again, using by Euclid's division lemma, there exist integers U and R such that A is equals to BQ plus R, where R is less than equals to 0 less than B. Here we have B is equals to 4, therefore A is equals to 4Q plus R, where 0 is less than is equals to R less than 4. Right? Means remainder is less than 4. So R is equals to 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay? Now we have A is equals to 4Q plus R. When R is equals to 0, A become फोर क्यू प्लस जीरो इज इक्वल्स टू फोर क्यू. सेकंड रिजल्ट व्हेन आर इज इक्वल्स टू वन देन ए इज इक्वल्स टू फोर क्यू प्लस आर इज इक्वल्स टू फोर क्यू प्लस वन. राइट, दिस इज फर्स्ट रिजल्ट, दिस इज सेकंड रिजल्ट. व्हेन आर इज इक्वल्स टू टू देन ए इज इक्वल्स टू फोर क्यू प्लस आर फोर क्यू आर इज इक्वल्स टू टू. राइट, दिस इज से रिजल्ट नंबर थ्री. व्हेन आर इज इक्वल्स टू थ्री देन वी हैव ए इज इक्वल्स टू फोर क्यू प्लस आर पुट द वे आर पुट आर इज इक्वल्स टू थ्री सो ए इज इक्वल्स टू फोर क्यू प्लस थ्री. दिस इज फोर्थ रिजल्ट. हेंस एनी ऑड इंटीजर ऑफ द फॉर्म इज फोर क्यू प्लस वन एंड रिजल्ट सेकंड एंड फोर्थ सो दैट एनी ऑड इंटीजर इज ऑफ द फॉर्म ऑफ फोर क्यू प्लस वन एंड फोर क्यू प्लस थ्री. दिस इज ऑल अबाउट टूडेज लेसन और टूडेज टॉपिक. थैंक यू सो मच.